Now let's take a closer look at hepatitis B. The hepatitis B virus reproduces in the liver, causing inflammation and possibly cirrhosis, liver failure, or liver cancer. When first infected, a person can develop an acute infection which can range in severity from a very mild illness with few or no symptoms to a serious condition requiring hospitalization. Acute hepatitis B refers to the first 6 months after someone is exposed to the hepatitis B virus. Now, some people are able to fight the infection and clear the virus. 90% or more of adults and older children who contract hepatitis B are likely to clear the virus from their systems within a few months and develop immunity. About 10% become chronic. The virus stays in their blood, infecting liver cells, damaging them over time and causing illness such as cirrhosis, liver failure, or liver cancer. Now, infants and young children are most at risk from chronic infections, complications, and death. Further, in most children, the virus is a silent killer. It destroys the liver or induces liver cancer, liver failure, or cirrhosis, often over a period of 20 years or more. It's estimated that up to 1.2 million people in the U.S. have chronic HBV infection. About 38,000 people per year become infected with HBV. Each year, about 3,000 people die as a result of liver disease caused by hepatitis B virus infection. Infections have significantly decreased since 1990 because of routine hepatitis B vaccination. Symptoms can be unreliable and may or may not be present. Only proper testing can determine the infection. Symptoms may include, but are not limited to, yellow skin, known as jaundice, yellowing of the eyes, tiredness, loss of appetite, nausea, dark-colored urine, joint pain, clay-colored stools, abdominal discomfort, and fever. Hepatitis B virus is up to 100 times easier to catch than HIV. This is because of several reasons, but for a couple, the virus is small compared to HIV, and also, HBV can live so long outside the body, at least 7 days, depending on the right conditions. It's mainly spread by sexual contact with an infected person or by sharing needles or syringes. It can also be spread from infected mother to her baby during birth or from contact with blood or body fluids through breaks in their skin, such as bites, cuts, or sores. People who are chronically infected can spread hepatitis B virus to others, even if they don't look or feel sick. However, like HIV, it's not spread by casual contact, such as handshakes, hugging, doorknobs, or using same equipment or public things like toilets and water fountains, which is a real blessing for us. Unlike HIV or hepatitis C, there is a vaccine for hepatitis B. It's usually given in 3 doses, given over a period of 6 months. Hepatitis B vaccine is made from non-infectious material and cannot cause HBV infection. It's a safe vaccine where severe problems or allergic reactions are rare. Hepatitis B vaccine is 80 to 95% effective in providing protection against hepatitis B when the complete series of 3 doses of vaccine are administered. Now, it's wise to have your immunity confirmed through an antibody testing 1 to 2 months after your series. Booster doses of hepatitis B vaccine are not recommended at this time. The HBV vaccine must be offered free to employees who face occupational exposure to bloodborne pathogens. Employees who do not want the vaccine must complete a vaccine declination form. Occupationally exposed employees include those who give tattoos, piercings, or other body art, administer first aid, provide medical aid, assist in bathroom care, work in a medical or dental office, perform custodial duties involving the cleaning and decontamination of surfaces that may be contaminated with blood and/or other potentially infectious materials, and/or handle regulated medical waste. So in general, any people with jobs that expose them to human blood or other body fluids must be offered the hepatitis B vaccine free of charge.